Hello student, welcome to our channel. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. Today we will discuss Analog and Digital Electronics Lab 18 CSL 37 of 3rd SEM IS and CS branch. So in this AD lab, we have two parts, part A and part B. In part A, we have experiment related to analog electronics. In part B, we have experiment related to digital electronics. In today's session, we will start with the experiment number 5, that is related to digital electronics of part B. So the experiment number 5 is given a 4 variable logical logic expression, simplify it using entered variable map and realize the simplified logic expression using 8:1 multiplexer. So let me repeat. Given a 4 variable logic expression, simplify it using entered variable map and realize the simplified logic expression using 8:1 multiplexer. So the function is given here, 4 variable. The function is given here, 4 variable, summation m, function of a 4 variable, summation m, and these are the minterms 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 12, 13, 14. These are the minterms. You have to simplify it by using entered variable map, and after that you have to simplify it using entered variable map. Then you have to realize it by using 8:1 multiplexer IC. So now first we'll see. So we know any Boolean expression can be minimized by using 4 to 5 methods. First method is Boolean law and theorem. Second method is K-map. In K-map, you have sum of product and product of sum. And third one is called as entered variable map or map entered variable. Fourth method is Q-map and Petrick methods. So, in this session, we'll see entered variable map. What is the entered variable map? So, entered variable map is the one in which one of the variable is represented inside the map as input. So, entered variable map is the one in which one of the variable, input variable, is represented inside the map. And what is the advantage of this one is it will reduce something like 4 variable map into 3 variable map. So, in this way we can simplify and we can deduce the expression. So, that is called as EVM or map entered variable. For the above problem statement, as shown here, let me first write the truth table. So, I will write the truth table here. Here already truth table is written. So, you can see here 4 variable truth table, and you know 4 variable truth table contains 16 combinations. So, I have given a different color to this this column. I have given a different color to this column. I will let you know later in this session. So now, after writing the truth table, you have to mark the corresponding minterms. For example, 0, 0, 0, that is minterm 0, that is there. Then we have minterm 1, we have minterm 2, minterm 3 is not there, 0, minterm 4 is there, minterm 5 is there, minterm 6 is there, minterm 7 is not there, minterm 8 is there, minterm 9 is there, then minterm 10 is not there, minterm 11 is not there, 12 is there, 13 is there, 14 is there, and 15 is not there. So once you represent all the output, now you have to isolate one of the variable, that is I am going to isolate the variable D. So separate color is given for this column. So I will isolate this column. That time, when you see only three inputs, A, B, C, then this looks like one group. This forms one group, 0, 0, 0. This forms one more group, 0, 0, 1. This forms third group or D2. This forms fourth group. This forms fifth group 10. This forms sixth group and seventh and last one is eighth group. So when you see only three variables, here you can form eight groups, and I will name the group as D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, etc. Now, so in this particular this group, you take the input D and see when there is the when the input is D is 0, output is 1. Input is 1, output is 1. That means when input changes from 0 to 1, output will not change. So output is remain same irrespective of input. So I will write here EVM, entered variable map, as 1. We will take the second case. When input is 0, output is 1. When input is 1, output is 0. That means output is the inverse of the input. Output is the inverse of the input. So I will write here D bar. Third one is, once again, output will remain same irrespective of input. So EVM is 1. Fourth one is, once again, output is the inverse of input, D bar. Fifth one is 1. Sixth one is, you see here, sixth one. So, D5 or sixth term, minterm 5 or D5 or in numerical it is sixth one. You see here, when input is 0, output is 0. When input is 1, output is 0. That means, output is 0 irrespective of input changes. So, I will take EVM as 0. So, next one is 1 and the next one is D bar. Like this, we have to make a note of, compute or calculate EVM variable. Once the EVM variable is calculated, then you have to further solve it by using K-map, three variable K-map. But in this session, we will write the circuit diagram from this EVM parameter. But for further solution of this one by using K-map, you have to refer my earlier videos. So in my earlier videos, I have explained how to solve this one by using K-map. So for the lab perspective view, we will try to draw the circuit diagram. So, we got EVM parameters, that is D01, D21, D41, D61. D5 is equal to 0. D1, D3, D7 is D bar. So, now we have to implement this one by using multiplexer. Now, what is multiplexer? Multiplexer is a device, electronic device, which has got many input and one output. Many means n input and one output. At a time, one of the input is moved to the output. One of the input is moved to the output based on the control lines. Based on the combination of the control lines. So, number of control lines depend on this formula. Like 2^m is equal to input line. For example, I want to design 8:1 mux. If I want to design 8:1 mux, in this case we have to design 8:1 mux. Then it has got 8 input lines and 1 output line. Control line is 2^3 means 8. Right. So M value is 3. Control lines means 3 control line is required, that is A, B, C. So 3 control lines, when A is A, B, C, value of A, B, C is equal to 0, 0, 0, D0 will get selected and moved to the output. When ABC is 001, D1 will be selected and moved to the output. 010, D2 will be selected and moved to the output. 011, D3 will be selected. 100, D4 will be selected. 101, D5 will be selected. 110, D6 will be selected. 111, D7 will be selected and moved to the output. So we have already reduced four variable expression into this one three variable by using EVM method. Now we have to implement this one using 8:1 multiplexer. 8:1 is the multiplexer is the one which has got 8 input lines. So that's why I represented EVM parameters as D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. These are the input to the multiplexer, and Y is the output, and number of control lines in the case of 8:1 is equal to 8:1 max is nothing but 3, ABC. So we will take ABC as the control lines. Okay, now let me draw the circuit diagram now first. So first I will draw this one diagram of 8:1 mux. So this is 8:1 mux. 8:1 mux. So this is the diagram for 8:1 mux. I am writing diagram for 8:1 mux. 8:1. As I said, 8:1 mux, which has got 8 lines starting from D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7. Other than that, we have something called as VCC. That is, this is 16 pin IC. Pin number 16 is VCC. We are using here 74151, IC number 74151, and pin number 8 is ground. Pin number 8 is ground. I will write here only ground. Pin number 8 is ground. Other than that, pin number 7 is called as a strobe signal. Pin number 7 is called as a strobe signal. Without this strobe signal, IC will not be enabled, strobe signal. So strobe signal, it is active low signal. You have to connect this into ground. Then only IC will get enabled. So pin number 8 is ground. So let me mark here ground. 5 is the output. 5 is the output. Pin number 5 is the output. Y. So D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. These are the pin name. Corresponding pin numbers are there. Demonstration will show you the corresponding pin number for D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. Now, I have to connect this one based on the EVM parameter. So, what EVM parameter says? D0, D2, D4 and D6. D0, D2, D4, D6 are 1. 1 means logical 1. Logical 1 means VCC, 5 volt. So D0, D2, D4, D6. Let me connect D0. So I will use different this one. Let me connect D0, D2, then D6 and D4 is there. Okay, D4. This goes to VCC. Logical one. Now, D5 is ground. You can see D5 is 0. You see here, D5 is 0. 0 means ground. So, let me connect D5. D5 is ground. Once again, D5 is connected to ground. Ground. So, after that, D5 is ground. After that, D1, D3, D7 is D bar. So, D1, D3, D7 is D bar. So, before that, I want to represent here control lines also. So, we have three control lines. I told you, we have three control lines, A, B, C. Let me write here control lines, A, B, C. So let me write here control lines. I will write here only A, B, C. These are the control lines. So in our expression, we have four variables, A, B, C, D. So D we are taking as a input. D, we are taking it as a input in the entered variable map. So, here D will take it separately. So, this is D, signal D. From signal D, I will connect this to one inverter. I will connect this one to the inverter. Output of the inverter is D bar. Output of the inverter is D bar. I will connect D bar to D1, D3, D7. So, D bar I will connect to D1, D3 and D7. Sorry. D7. I will connect it to D7. So, this is the signal. So, now you can see here we have 4 variables A, B, C, D. In this way, we will implement the 8:1 MUX. So by using 74151 IC. 74151 is a 16-pin IC. In that, 16 is VCC and 8 is ground and 7 is a strobe signal. Please remember this one. Strobe signal you have to connect to the ground. It is an active low signal. You have to connect it to the ground. If you connect this signal to the ground, then only this IC will be enabled and IC will work. Otherwise, IC will not work. So, this is the circuit diagram connectivity. Rest of the things we will see in the demonstration session. Thank you.
Today, we will try to implement your fifth experiment. That is, given a 4 variable logic expression, simplify it using entered variable map and realize it with using 8:1 multiplexer. So, here expression is given. How to solve this expression by using EVM method, I have just explained you earlier. So, the expression is y is equal to function of 4 variable summation m. Summation m in the sense, all these are min terms. So, required components are, here we need 8:1 multiplexer and one NOT gate IC. So, this is the IC we are using. This is the IC, 16-pin IC. This is the IC number is 74151. It is a 8:1 multiplexer. Along with this IC, we are using one NOT gate. So, along with this IC, we are using NOT gate. I have already explained you how to draw the circuit diagram for the said problem, like function of 4 variable. Now, this is the circuit diagram. In the circuit diagram, we are using 16-pin IC. In that, pin number 16 is VCC and pin number 8 is ground. Other than that, we have one more pin that is called a strobe pin. You have to connect pin number 7 to ground. When you connect this pin number 7 to ground, then only this IC will get enabled. Other than that, these are the data pins. 4, 3, 2, 1, all these are data pins. For example, pin number 4 is D0, pin number 3 is D1, pin number 2 is D2, pin number 1 is D3. Other than this, we have control lines A, B, C. Pin number 9, 10, 11 is the control lines. Pin number 9, 10, 11 is the control lines A, B, C. And Y is the output. This is the trainer kit. In the last class, last session, I told you about the trainer kit. Please refer that video. So now, I am going to insert this IC in the IC holder. First, release the latch. And you have to see the which is the pin number 1 in IC. This is the pin number 1. You can see the notch is there. The pin next to the notch, left side, is pin number 1. So, insert the IC into the IC holder. Now, IC is connected. Similarly, I will connect one more IC, that is NOT gate IC. So, this IC is also connected. Now, I will do the VCC and ground connection. For that, I will use the patch cable or patch cords. So, for 74151 IC, this is the multiplexer IC. For this, pin number 16 is VCC. And other than that, pin number 8 is ground. So, I will connect pin number 8 to the ground and pin number 16 is a VCC. So you can see here, pin number 16 is VCC, pin number 8 is ground. Other than that, we have pin number 7, that is strobe signal, that you have to connect it to ground. So I will take one more patch called, and I will connect pin number 7 to this cable like this, and I will connect this to pin number 8. Now pin number 7 and 8 are shorted together, and that is connected to ground. Pin number 7 and 8 are shorted, and from pin number 8 one connection goes to ground. Pin number 16 is connected to VCC. So now we will connect VCC and ground for 7404 IC. So for 7404 IC, it is a NOT gate. Here, since it is a 14 pin IC, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. After 7, this pin becomes 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So this is not 16, this is 14, because we are using here 14 pin IC. So connect pin number 14 to VCC, and connect one more, take one more wire and connect pin number 7 to ground. Please remember, in 7404, pin number 7 is ground, pin number 14 is VCC. So pin number 7 is ground and pin number 14 is VCC. So now ground and VCC connections are done. So students, in this IC 74151, pin number 0, pin number 4, D0, then D2, then D4 and D6 is connected to VCC. You can see here. Let me repeat, D6, D4, D2 and D0 connected to VCC. So that means pin number 4 and pin number 2, pin number 15 and pin number 13 are connected to VCC. Let me connect that. First, I will take the patch cord. So pin number 4. So 74151. 74151. Pin number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pin number 4 is connected to. Pin number 2. So which is pin number 2 here? Pin number 2. From pin number 2, it is goes to pin number 15. So pin number 2 goes to pin number 15. So from pin number 2, I will connect in this way. This is called the tapping. Pin number 2. One more connection goes to pin number 15. This is the 15th connection. Pin number 15. From 15, one more connection goes to pin number 13. So from 15, take the tapping, something like this, and one more connection goes to pin number 13. So we have connected pin number 4, 2, 15 and 13. And finally, this goes to VCC. So what should I do is, now we have to short this. You have to connect final this to VCC. So from here only I will take one connection, and I will connect that to VCC. You can see here 5 volt. I will connect to this connection. I will tap it and I will connect like this. So it is connected to VCC. Here pin number 14 is D5. It is connected to ground. Let me connect that first, pin number 14. So pin number 14, you can see pin number, this is the pin number 14. I will connect it to ground. So you can see here, this is the ground connection. This is pin number 14 is connected to ground. That means pin number 14 is 0. Rest of the pin are VCC. Now I will connect control signals. You know, 8 is to 1 mux, we have 3 control lines, A, B, C. First, let me connect this one, A, B, C. Pin number 9 is A, that is MSB. B is 10, C is 11, C is LSB. LSB means a least significant width. Let me connect ABC to control lines. So, pin number 9, you can see here, pin number 9, I will connect to input where I am giving control signal A. Then pin number 10, I will connect to B. Then pin number 11, I will connect to D. Sorry, C, A, B, C. These are the control signals. So, in 8:1 MUX, depending on the control signals, 0, 0, 0, particular line will be selected. 0, 0, 1, D1 will be selected. 0, 1, 0, D2 will be selected. So on. Now, we will connect rest of the connections here. So, you know, we have to simplify 4 variable expression into 3 variable. So, in 4 variable, you have one more variable D. So, here you can see the one more variable D that goes through the inverter. That goes through the inverter, and output of the inverter is connected to, output of the inverter is connected to the point D7, D3 and D1. I have already explained you how to solve this expression, 4 variable expression, by using EVM method. And the EVM outputs are, these are the EVM outputs. D0 is 1, D1 is D bar, D2 is equal to 1, D3 is D bar, D4 is 1, D5 is 0, D6 is 1, D7 is D bar. That means pin number D7, D3 and D1 are D bar. That's why I will connect D as input to the inverter, output of the inverter is D bar. D bar goes to pin number D7, pin number D3 and pin number D1. So, I will take one more signal, input signal. So, this is the one more input signal, D. This goes as an input to the 7401 inverter. Output of the 7401, here you can see in the diagram, output of the 7401 goes to pin number 12 or D7 of 74151 MUX. So, pin number 12. So, here you can see pin number 12, I will connect it here, pin number 12. And from here only, pin number 12, one more point goes to pin number 1, that is D3. So, what I will do is, I will take one tapping from this point, pin number 12, I will take one tapping, like this, and this goes to pin number 1. So, you can see here, 74151, pin number 1 is here, you can see, pin number 1, so I will connect it here. From same point, once again, you will see here, from pin number 1, this point, one more connection goes to pin number 3. Pin number 3. You can see here. Pin number 3. So, let me take one more tapping from pin number 1. Like this. Pin number 1. One more tapping from pin number 1. And connection goes to pin number 3. Pin number 3. So, we have done all the connections except output connection. So, output is nothing but pin number 5. Pin number 5 is the output. So, let me connect pin number 5. You can see here, pin number 5 goes to output. You can connect it anywhere. Let me connect it here only. Pin number output. So, here pin number 6 is the complement output. That is not required. We want to see only one output. Why? We don't want complement output. So, let me summarize here. We have taken 74151 IC. This is 8:1 MUX. Then we have taken one more NOT gate. So, this is the control signal A, B, C, D and this is the output. And we have to switch on this trainer kit and we have to see the output for the corresponding input. Now I am going to switch on the trainer kit. Already connection has been done. You know here, connection has been done. So here you see control signals A, B, C, D, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now you can see 0, 0, 0, 0, output is 1. So you can see here, corresponding output is 1. Corresponding output is 1. Now I will change second combination 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. The output is 1. Let me go to third combination 0, 0, 1, 0. The output is 1. Fourth combination, you see here, fourth combination 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Output is 0, 0, 1, 1. Output is 0. 0, 1, 1. Output is 0. So next combination, let me move to the next combination 0, 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0, 0. Output is 1. So similarly, we will move to the last combination 1, 1, 1, 1. So 1, 1, 1, 1. Output is 0. So you need to check the output for all combinations of A, B, C, D. In this way, you can implement 4 variable. You can simplify 4 variable expression into 3 variable by using EVM. And you can implement practically by using 8:1 MUX. Thank you.